Hey there, it's Board Game Dave. This past weekend, I was in Philly attending PAX Unplugged, which is one of the biggest board game conventions in the United States, and I had an absolute blast. It was my first ever board game convention, and it was so much fun learning about new games, meeting new people, walking around the demo hall, and playing a whole bunch of new games. There's so much I want to say about PAX, but I'm going to try to organize my thoughts into four main categories: the games, the loot, the people, and the overall experience. Let's start with the games. I played 10 different games this weekend, two of which were partial plays, and two of which I had already played before. So today I'm just gonna talk about my five most notable games that I played at PAX, starting with number five, Bitoku. Bitoku is a gorgeous, sprawling game that's a lot to take in at first. It's got wonderful, lovely art and components, and the theme is just absolutely fantastic. It's all about Japanese spirits and mythical creatures. You've got Imamushi and Kappa and Okami. It's all very Ghibli-esque, and they even mention Miyazaki in the acknowledgments. As somebody who grew up watching a lot of Ghibli movies, especially Princess Mononoke, I was instantly captivated as soon as I saw the Bitoku booth, and I knew that I wanted to try this game out. So, full disclosure, we only played 1 year out of the 4 years in the game, but my first impression of the game was that it was just a little bit too much. There's so much going on in this game, and even after an hour of playing, it was hard to tell how the different actions and mechanisms clicked together. It all just felt a little bit disjointed and like too much crammed into one game. That being said, we didn't play a full game, so maybe by the end of the game I would have been able to see some of the synergies between the different actions. A lot of heavy games are like that. You need a game or two to be able to see the big picture. So that's just my first impression of Bitoku. I'd be absolutely down to give it another try. Number four was Crokinole. Now, I can't stress this enough, I don't really consider Crokinole a board game. If Crokinole's a board game, then so is billiards, so is ping pong. I'm almost convinced there's some kind of conspiracy going on that's got Crokinole ranked number 5 on the BGG Best Family Board Games. What is up with that? Conspiracy theories aside, I did play Crokinole for the first time at PAX, and I had a lot of fun with it. Incidentally, the guy that taught us how to play Crokinole is also a YouTuber. His name is Max from Table Knots, and he was a great teacher. You should check out his channel right there. Number three is a small game called Furnace. I had seen a lot of this game on the board game Instagram, and it kind of gave me some Brass Birmingham vibes, so I definitely wanted to try it out at PAX. Luckily, we had a chance to play, and it was a really great game. There's a lot of engine and tableau building where you buy these industries to turn coal into steel, steel into oil. You get these upgrade tokens that let you flip over your industries that makes them more efficient. But the game really revolves around bidding for those industry cards, and it has such a clever and refreshing take on that whole bidding mechanism. After we played the game, I was almost ready to buy it then and there until my friend Connor brought up the replayability. As much fun as that first game was, I'm not sure about the longevity of this game. There are 5 different asymmetrical roles you can play as, but once you've played them all, I feel like the game could just get a little dry. That's not to say that it's a bad game though, and the more that I think about it, the more I really do want to play it again, so it's definitely worth checking out Furnace. Number two was Khôra, Rise of an Empire. This is a civilization game set in ancient Greece, but really it comes down to moving yourself up in various tracks. In fact, there are 7 tracks that you're going to be advancing along in this game: citizens, tax, glory, troops, economy, culture, and military. Each track offers its own advantages, and you'll be rolling dice and playing actions that correspond with each of those different tracks. Throughout the course of the game, you'll be developing your own civilization, sending out your military to conquer and explore new lands, dealing with different events, and completing various achievements. It's a fairly involved game that still plays quickly and teaches easily, which I love. I definitely would have played it again if we would have had the time, and Gary liked it so much that he ordered the game the same day that we played it, so we very much liked Khôra Rise of an Empire. It's a great game. And finally, my most notable and my favorite game from PAX was Origins First Builders by Board and Dice. Origins, to me, felt a lot like Teotihuacan, also by Board and Dice. You're putting your dice out on the board, they upgrade, eventually they ascend, and the whole time you're competing with other players for action spots on the board. It almost feels too much like Teotihuacan, and I love it. There are 2 big things that you do in Origins that you don't do in Teotihuacan. One is building your own city and using your dice to activate buildings in that city. The second is building towers inside your city, which become multipliers for big endgame scoring. I love that part of the game. although I really didn't focus on it enough. If you haven't checked out Origins First Builders yet, you definitely should. It's a fantastic game, and the designer Adam Kwapinski has a track record for putting out great games. So those were some of the games that I played at PAX Unplugged. Now let's talk about the loot. I wish I had a big PAX haul video with like 40 board games that I bought this weekend, but I actually didn't buy any board games at PAX. Although, that doesn't mean that I didn't get a lot of cool stuff. Let's take a look inside my bag. First, I got this phenomenal game mat from gamermats.com, link in the description. It's beautiful, it's durable, it's gorgeous. I love this mat, and they had such a great collection. I wish I could have bought more than one, but this is the one I chose, and I love it. Next, I got a set of dice that I am inordinately, inexplicably excited about, and these were only $3.99. There's something really satisfying about getting my first set of dice. Now I've got a D4, a D6, a D8, a D10, a D12, and a D20, and they all match. A lot of fan-made solo variants call for D8s and stuff, so I'm really glad to have these. I also apparently got a cat at PAX Unplugged. Hello! But no, what I did get are these great Teotihuacan tiles. So my friend was buying Tewantin Suyu, and while we were checking out, I was talking about how much I love Teotihuacan. Well, the person ringing us up overheard me and gave me totally for free these upgraded wooden decoration tiles for Teotihuacan with some promo tiles included, totally for free. That was definitely one of the highlights of my weekend. And lastly, I got this wonderful rubber ducky, which transitions us nicely to the people that I met at PAX. This, of course, came from Quackalope. I was able to talk to Jesse for a bit on Sunday, and he was such a wonderful guy, really down to earth, and he was really encouraging about the whole YouTube thing. And this duck is probably gonna be up on this shelf for forever. I also got to spend some time with David from Man vs. Meeple, who has been really supportive of this channel from almost the very beginning. He is a really, really great guy. I also got to talk to Nick and Sarah from Meeples on the Ground. I spent a lot of time with Steve and Rosanna from Dragon Tower Games. I saw Professor Meg. I saw Our Family Plays Games. I got to talk to Gnarly Carly. I saw both of the brothers Murph, and I even got to see a live in-person podcast with the crew from Shut Up and Sit Down. Amazing! I've been in the board game hobby for about 3 years now, and I'm sure I've watched thousands of YouTube videos about board games, and it was crazy to see some of these people that I've always seen behind a screen in real life, in person. I'm like, holy crap, I could go say hi to that person right now. It was just so cool to meet and connect with some of these people that have a platform that they use to spread the joy of board gaming. So how would I rate my first ever board game convention experience overall? I mean, what else can I say? I loved all of it. I loved learning new games, I loved playing old games, I loved meeting new people, and even just sharing a space with thousands of people who love board games as much as I do. I mean, that was a treat right there. I mean, really, I just love seeing people play good games. Like, I saw people setting up Sagrada, and I was like, oh my gosh, I love that game. Or people are playing Boon Lake, and I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm such a big Alexander Pfister fan, you know? And they get it. Like, that excitement, that joy of board games is why I started this channel. I loved being at PAX Unplugged. I loved being around all those people who are so passionate about board games, and I hope some of that passion comes through in my videos as well. I would love to be just a small part of sharing the joy of board games with all of you. Anyway, what's your favorite board game convention memory? Maybe you've been to Origins or Gen Con or Essenspiel, or maybe you were just at PAX Unplugged like me. Either way, let me know in the comments down below. And in the meantime, have a wonderful week, take care, and happy gaming. Bye. I'm ready to start. Here we go, everybody. First take, first take, first wonder. That's me. something's fishy about. Let's talk loot and or booty.
Oh, I'm like, why is this happening? What? My pecs are busting out of my shirt.
I'm taking the pants off. I'm done.